Soder had brought two engines to the Northwestern Railway to help out taking passengers to Olstead Castle. They were converted from a loading engine as they were brought from America. There were two engines. One was named Catlin, and the other was named Connor. I beat you. Oh, well, said Connor one day as they approached an old station. There, Stephen came in.
Hello, you two. How are you two doing? Good?
That evening, they were at the sheds. Connor was boasting about being converted to the loading gauge.
You know, I can go anywhere peacefully under those small tunnels.
You know, Connor, it won't work out that easily.
Yeah, once I crash into a brake van.
Oh, yes, I've been converted, but I still have to be careful.
Me too, said Hank.
And me, said Sam.
Whatever,
said Connor. He'll soon learn it eventually. I warned him.
But Connor paid no attention. He was too busy being conceited about the loading gauge change.
You know, I've heard some stories about some narrow gauge engines that were American.
Yeah, they wrecked. They were turned into a generator, I hear.
Yep. Yeah, he didn't care a damn for a few spills. He was incorrectly, he was converted, but I don't think they did that well. You know, you never can be too careful, Connor, said Hank.
Whatever, said Connor. Hank, the other engines were worried, but they knew Connor was going to get what he deserved.
Anyway, I warned him.
Yeah, didn't we all? Connor was conceited, and the next day, he was busy going very fast. He went to an after station to go to the ship to turn around, but he was going so fast that he didn't realize the points.
Oh no, whoa! He derailed off the line. The points were too small, and he went off the line.
He was lifting a back on, but he had to go to the works to mend it, as he needed a lot of repairs. Oh dear. Donald and Douglas took him to the works. Douglas took a sender while Donald took the breakdown train with Connor on it.
I need an engine.
Yes, we need an engine, said the Earl, to help out with it. Has any volunteers?
To help out with the tools.
I can, said Murdoch.
Splendid, Murdoch. You'll start tomorrow.
Catlin will show you the way. Murdoch didn't know anything about Catlin. Little did he know that Catlin would be trouble for him. The next morning, Murdoch woke up bright and early and met Catlin.
Hello, you must be Murdoch. I'm Catlin. How are you doing?
Good, I hope. Well, the Earl of Soda is very happy. You know, I'm from America. You know, in America, it's very big and bustling. You know, this station's quite big. It reminds me of a station, but the guard blew his whistle and Murdoch was in luck. Thank goodness. Murdoch was in the countryside. There he saw Catlin. Murdoch, you're delayed. Don't worry, I'll wait here for you.
Wait, what?
Why? Oh, I want peace and quiet. Murdoch. But Murdoch went ahead and had to go to Olstead Station. So Murdoch did. He told Stephen all about it. Stephen laughed, told Murdoch that she'd come down eventually. But that's the exact opposite.
Are you sure? I'm sure she will.
You know, back in my day, everyone was all so happy about being, like, in the rain hill trials, we'd all race. Connor and Caitlin remind me of it. Why don't you just stay around her for a bit?
I guess.
She'll come down eventually.
I doubt it.
Caitlin was surprisingly still there waiting for me, and the two went away. Murdoch was very and Murdoch tried to speed up from Caitlin, but Caitlin soon caught up.
Hello, Murdoch. Murdoch, are you awake?
Oh my goodness, can you go back?
I am now. Can you please let me have some sleep?
Oh, I'm sorry.
you awake?
Still about to sleep.
Can you please just give me some peace and quiet? It happened over and over again. Murdoch was getting irritated. Please go back to sleep. I need rest for tomorrow. Can I just have some peace and quiet at last? Said Murdoch. What are engines coming to these days? No, my goodness. Please, Caitlin. Murdoch had a plan. What if I go before Caitlin? So he got up early, Philip and Cole, and was soon ready. All the passengers were early, were already there, so Murdoch had no problems getting up, going. Murdoch went so fast. Murdoch was soon a couple of the coaches and soon left. Murdoch went so fast that he went before Nia, who was taking a good strain, but so Nia was sent on Murdoch's line, and Murdoch was sent toward where Nia was supposed to go. This caused a lot of trouble as Murdoch went to an area. He forgot to fill up on water. He only filled up on coal, as he was too busy trying to get rushed in the morning. Then there was trouble. Murdoch ran out of water in the middle of the heavy industrial area. Oh no, said Murdoch. Oh no, noises were everywhere. Booming noises, bang. Oh no. His driver and fireman went to go call for help. Murdoch was annoyed by the noises. Finally, help soon arrived. Murdoch? Caitlin, am I glad to see you.
So am I. Here, I'll help you.
So, Caitlin coupled up her coaches and Murdoch, and soon the two left. Caitlin, I'm sorry I was a bit rude to you. I'm sorry. Can we be friends?
Of course we can. Were we ever not?
I'm good we can work this out. Me too. And the two friends chuffed away.
Indeed.